Morning, good morning, everybody. My name is Yuko, and I am a happiness promoter and a student of A Course in Miracles. And in my videos, I talk about the lessons that I'm going over that day, and according to A Course in Miracles, and my take, and also whatever the heck is coming up to me. So today is lesson 60, and I think this is the last part of the part one preview. Yay! So let's talk. Okay, so today's five lessons are Goddess. God is the love in which I forgive. God is the strength in which I trust. There's nothing to fear. God's voice speaks to me all through the day, and I'm sustained by the love of God. How beautiful are these, guys? This is so beautiful. God is the love in which I forgive. God is the strength in which I trust. There's nothing to fear. God's voice speaks to me all through the day, and I am sustained by the love of God. Just give me chills, and I can get over how awesome these are. And the one that I really wanted to focus on today for me was the fourth one, and God's voice speaks to me all through the day. And the reason I chose this is because there is not a mountain in which God's voice ceases to call my forgiveness to save me. There is not a moment in which His voice fails to direct my thoughts, guide my actions, and lead my feet. I am walking steadily on towards truth. There is nowhere else I can go because God's voice is the only voice and the only guide that has been given to His Son. I mean, I don't think I need to speak any farther than that, right? I don't think I need to speak anymore because this is it. There's nothing else. Like, no matter what I say or what I do or how I would share, I don't think I can sum it up better than this. There's nowhere else I can go because God's voice is the only voice and the only guide that has been given to His Son. And I've been doubting a lot of things. Like, even though I've been, like, going in a better direction per se, right? Like, I've been like, I have my ons and off. I have my on and off, and my good times are really good, and my bad times, like, I really doubt myself and say, like, why is this happening to me? Like, right? Like, why can I do this better? Why can I not feel the way that I want to? And those are the time I would love to pray, but those are the time I forget. So in order for me to remember that, like, I really get to remember that with an intention, set, and say, this is what I want to remember. And yesterday, I was watching this training that I'm doing, and I forgot the name of the exact book. I think it was like, Willpower Does Not Work. I can't remember the name of the author, but Willpower Does Not Work. And the reason the willpower does not work is because the person has not decided that that is the thing I want. Decide as in decide, right? Side is to cut off and decide. Like, really, really make the decision and say, this is what I want. And so, have you made the decision to that is really what you want? And in the previous exercise that I was doing was Tim Ferriss thing, and that was also shared in the training, said, like, instead of goal setting, what about we do the fear setting, right? And like, a goal setting, when we set the goal, when we want to go high and go farther, there are a few kicks in, right? Whether that is a fear of doubt, fear of success, fear of rejection, whatever that may be, the fear comes in. So why don't we just face those fears instead of looking into the goals and get overwhelmed, feeling all this fear and shutting down, right? We face that fear from the get-go. Yeah, I thought when I heard that was brilliant, right? So as I was going through it, one of the things was like when I share what I want, people use it against me, right? That is a huge one. And also, when I do communicate what I want, I'm going to hurt people that I care. So those are like a double-edged sword, right? Like, I can share what I want to do, and when I do share, and then I hurt people. So Like, I'm really good at declaring things. I'm really good at this is what I want to do. This is what I do want to do. Although the things are sounds good, but how am I really making a decision? Saying it is easy, putting it out there is easy. But am I in integrity between what I'm saying and what I'm deciding in my heart? That has been a really good thing for me. And do I really want it? And I never knew that those were the beliefs that I had, right? And by not asking myself, by not making the decision and say this is what I want, I'm protecting myself to communicate from other people. I'm protecting myself to connect with other people, because the story up until this moment was that if I know what I want and if I tell that, I'm gonna hurt people, or they're gonna use it against me. So why do I even want to decide that this is what I want? I don't want to get hurt. I don't want to be alone, right? And it all makes sense. And all that, this is very interesting. And that's another point. Is it like, has it been always true? Is it really the truth? Are there a time in the time of the day, a time in my life, like I communicated what I want and people actually supported me? Yes, there are so many times that people have supported me. And when there are times that were communicated and they were happy for me. Yes, they were so happy for me. So there are a few occasions that really triggers and create the story for me. And yet there are actually only less than a handful of occasions as compared to what was actually going on. So I was looking for the evidence. Okay, is this really true? Right? What evidence are you looking for in your life? I guess the universe is telling me, yeah. Like, this is the right thing to be communicating, so thank goodness. See, and that goes back to that God's voice speaks to me all through the day. God, it's so good, guys. And if you don't want to use the word God, you can use the universe, the love, the one, the higher self, the spirit, whatever that communicates you. It's something that's bigger than you. And not only in a spiritual sense, but also in the quantum physics, right? And I'm not a scientific person, and I just use the word quantum physics, but all the other people use it, so it sounds so cool. And science are catching up to all the things that people have been doing centuries and centuries ago. So all right, I got in a little tangent, I feel like, but today's lesson, the reviews are really, really powerful, as I always say, because all these lessons are powerful, right? And if you have any comment, please leave a comment.